See students, you completed addition, subtraction and scalar multiplication. See the difference. You did a scalar multiplication, but here what we are doing? We are doing a multiplication of the matrices. We are multiplying two matrices. And if I explain the definition, it is little bit difficult to understand. So I'm explaining in general. Suppose you have to take a matrix of order M by N and B is a matrix of order N by P. And you know that M is what? M is the number of row. What is N? N is the number of columns. Like that in the next one. Here it is the number of row and this is the number of columns. When you are multiplying two matrices, write on that two matrices side by side exactly below. Write on that order. If these two values are same, what is that meaning? Number of columns in matrix A. A is first matrix. Number of columns in matrix A is equal to number of row in matrix B. Then only you can multiply AB and the resulting matrix have the order M by P. Is it clear? A is a matrix of order M by N. B is a matrix of order N by P. That means here number of columns, here number of rows. If they are equal, then only we can multiply AB. And finally, the matrix AB is another matrix. Its order is M by P. Suppose, if A is a matrix of order 2 by 2 and B is a matrix of order 2 by 3. See here these values. This is what? This is a number of columns. And what about this? This is a number of row. This is column. Column of what? Column of matrix A. And this here it is row of matrix B. If they are equal, then only you can multiply A and B. And what is the resulting matrix have? The resulting matrix have 2 by 3 order. That means AB is of order 2 by 3. So before going to the definition, first I will explain the examples. So as I told, before definition, I am giving you the example first. See the example, two matrices are given. So and before multiplication, what is your work? We have to check whether the multiplication is possible or what. For that, write on A and B on the side. After writing A and B, write on the order of matrix A. What is the order? Matrix A has 2 by 3 and matrix B has 3 by 2. Write on here. This is 2 by 3 and 3 by 2. Suppose if you are not remember any condition, just write like this and see these numbers. If they are equal, that means the number of columns and the number of row in these two matrices are equal, you can multiply AB and its order is 2 by 2. Now observe this multiplication carefully. Here first write on AB. Write on the matrix A. After writing A and B, the next step is very important. So how to multiply? First row is multiplied with first column. Writing, I am writing like this. First column. Remember, this is not necessary step. But to understand the problem, I am giving this step. First row, the corresponding elements. First row corresponding elements are multiplied with first column. After that, leave some place. Then first row with second column. Yes, students, note down this. After coming, this completes the first one. Next, moving to the next. Second row with first column. Then I think you can see that what is the next? Second row with second column. This is understood. So now I am multiplying the corresponding elements that I will explain very slowly here. See, first row with the first column, again in that corresponding elements. How corresponding element? 1 into 2. And after every corresponding element multiplication middle, we have to write plus. See the corresponding element, 1 into 2. In this I am explaining each and everything. 1 into 2. After first element multiplication middle, we have to write plus. Moving to the next element, minus 1 into minus 1. Again middle, plus. Third element, 2 into 5. Yes. This completes what? First row with first column. Then, leave some place. After leaving some place, first row with second column. In that also, you have to multiply the corresponding elements. That is, 1 into 7. Plus, what is the next element? Minus 1 into 1. Then, 2 into minus 4. After that, see, second row with first column, corresponding elements, 0 into 2. After first element multiplication, middle, plus. Then tell me what is the next? 3 into minus 1. Then, 4 into 5. So this completes second row with first column. Leave some place. Second row with second column, corresponding elements. Then 3 into 1. Then 4 into minus 4. Now multiply this. 2 minus into minus plus. 2 5 is 10. Similarly, the next one. 7 minus 1. Minus 8. What is the next? 0 minus 3 plus 20. See the next? 0 plus 3 minus 16. See, after simplification, what you will get? 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 10, 13. It is 7 minus 1 minus 8 minus 2. Minus 3 plus 20, that is 17. And it is minus 13. And already you are familiar. See here, already we explained that when you multiply AB, the AB will be the another matrix of order 2 by 2. See this order, is it 2 by 2 or what? This is of order 2 by 2. But here we have a two questions. The second one is BA. Second one, before multiplying, first see whether the multiplication is possible or what. For that, on the side write on B and A, and below that write on their orders. What is B has order? 3 by 2. And what is the order of A? 2 by 3. As I told you, suppose if you not remember the condition, write like this and see these adjacent numbers. If they are equal, go for the multiplication. And the resulting matrix BA have order 3 by 3. So note down on side, I kept this as it is, so we can compare with the final answer. Now I am writing BA. First write down that matrices. So after writing a matrices, go for corresponding multiplication. So as I explained in the previous, first row with first column, see carefully, first row with first column, again in that corresponding elements, 2 into 1 plus 7 into 0. First row with first column completes, leave some place, first row with second column. Corresponding elements. Then first row with third column, corresponding elements, 2 into 2. Then 7 into 4. This completes first row with first column, first row with second column, first row with third column. Then second row with first column plus 1 into 0. This is second row with first column. Then second row with second column plus 1 into 3. Second row with third column. Yes. After that, third row with first column corresponding elements. Then second row with second column corresponding elements. Third row with third column. After writing, multiply them. 2 plus 0 minus 2 plus 21, 4 plus 28. Then minus 1 plus 0, minus into minus plus. Then minus 2 plus 4. See the next. 5 plus 0, minus 5 minus 12. The next one is 10 minus 16. Simplify them. It is 2. Minus 2 plus 21 will be 19. Then it is 32. And minus 1. 4. 2. 5. Minus 17. And it is minus 6. See the order. Order is 3 by 3. See before without multiplication also we got the answer or what? The order is 3 by 3. Here also the order is 3 by 3. Now, with this example, we are moving to the definition. So, you can understand the definition easily. Now, see the definition. The product of two matrices A and B is defined if the number of columns of A, that is matrix A, is equal to the number of rows in B. And you know that this is a general representation. Let A is equal to Aij, B an M by N matrix, and B is equal to Bij, B an N by P matrix, then the product of the matrices A and B is the matrix C. And its order is M by P. See, this is how we are defining multiplication of matrices. And don't take tension if you are not following. Again, I am explaining some more example on product of matrices.